So today we're gonna have to change the tire on this baby. We all know about the plug. Plug is, you spin it around here. Could have went the other way. Plug is still there, it's still holding, but yeah, as heavy as this bike is, and it's already starting to, that split's starting to get bigger. So I have decided to go ahead and just change the tire. You can actually see something has stabbed it there. I nearly missed one there, and then it looks like I've got a couple more stabs right under this one. It's starting to split. So that hole, I'm going to say, is very bad from the inside. I'm just lucky it held this long. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to consult our book. This is my cheat sheet that I made. So for my rear wheel, yeah, this is easy. T50. I want to put it back on 60 Newton meters. I made this cheat sheet up. If you want this cheat sheet, just message me, and I can send it to you. It's got everything in here that you need. It's just a good quick reference that I keep in my bag with my road book, just in case something happens. I've got a quick reference to do everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and break out my 250 and my ratchet and get this wheel off. So one other thing before we forget. These bolts on the back are a T30, therefore taking the back fender door open. Here's some ASMR for you. And this makes it a whole lot easier to get this tire out. And then when you drop the wheel, it just rides right out. And we're gonna reach across here and put her in first gear. That'll help keep the wheel from spinning while we're trying to get the lugs off. Small extension, 4-inch, 6-inch should be plenty. I've got an adapter on this one because the only torques I could find were a 3-inch drive, and my big ratchet is a half. I got 3-8s, but it sure is easier with a half. So let's get this bad boy off here. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. Maybe I'm weak in my old age. Or it could just be that my torque wrench is 3 feet long and it's just a lot easier to get it on. It's a lot easier to get it on with a 3-foot ratchet than it is to get it off with a 2-foot ratchet. And I believe while we have this off, we're going to go ahead and check our level in our final drive. And thanks to our prep, the door's already up and she rolls right out. Take a look at our brake pads while she's up in the air. Our gap looks good. So yeah, I'm calling it. I think she's good. Now that it's off the bike, you can probably see it a little better, I hope. Whatever I hit on this thing, it did a job on it. It took a nick out of the tire there. And here's the hole, but on both sides of the hole, hope you can see this on film. There's a split on both sides, and then there's 3 splits around the hole, so I'm just kind of lucky that held. So that's our tire, our new tire. I do like my Metzlers. So I got another Rotec Z8. the O-rated one because heavy duty. This one actually held up really good. I'm happy with it, except that once it got a hole in it, it blew. It actually did hold up. It was a really good drive. It handled fantastically. So I am gonna do this tire again. I do not have the right adapter to balance it myself with that hub yet. So I am gonna bring it into the shop and have them do it in the shop. Alright, so we're at the Voodoo Cafe in Bartlett, and we have gone with the man-sized beignets, apparently, with two Vietnamese coffees. Now, he gave me some feta and honey and pistachio to try with this. It's supposed to be very good. So let me apply this sparingly. Let's see what happens. A little bit on his arm.
The dolls.
I can't place it, but it actually does taste good. It makes it not sweet. I'll get back to you on that. And she's gonna take the last one. Voodoo Cafe in Bartlett, and has a very unique flair to it. Yeah, being from Louisiana, I mean, this is some really cool and out there stuff. So this is the owner.
Hi there.
And his trusted assistant.
That's Robin, I'm Mark.
So would you like to tell us a little bit about the place?
Sure, all the art in here is all from local artists. The name is Voodoo Cafe, which is more of a inspired New Orleans thing versus anything else. I've always loved New Orleans, and I like that hidden garden kind of thing. So that's kind of what we tried to capture here. So come on down and have a cup of coffee. And
I noticed the beignets are shaped like voodoo dolls.
Little voodoo dolls, yep. So people get a chuckle out of that whenever they see them for the first time. So yeah, that's about it.
Right.
You gotta try the food.
All right, so we gotta get back to the cycle shop now. They just called and said the tire's ready, so we're gonna get there and pick that up. And I'll see you back in my garage. All right, so we have the tire back. It's mounted, and it is exactly like the other one, except it does not have holes in it. I did have him check the inside of the tire to see why it wouldn't hold plugs, but I mean, we didn't come up with anything. He said the inside looked fine. I think it was just because it was the diagonal hole. The way the nail went in was diagonal, and it just kept seeping around the small edges, and I think that's why it had little splits. But either way, got a new tire on it, so we'll get it on. All right, so we got our Newton meters. We are supposed to have 60 Newton meters. So I took it to 61, then backed it off one. So now we're at 60 Newton meters. So saith the number. One bolt ready to go. Still got her in first gear where she doesn't take off on me. On this side, maybe. We got plenty of anti-seize on still from last time. Don't want to overdo it. I don't think it goes bad. I live by FedEx, did I mention? While we're down here, I can show you. So this thing here, that right there, that's the thing that BMW had convinced me would shatter and kill me. I actually could have probably ordered that online and did it myself. It's kind of depressing to know that I didn't ride for a month because of that thing. Eh, is what it is. All right, let's get our tire on. Those beignets earlier were fantastic, by the way. Throw that out there. Star pattern, which on a 5 lug just means hit every other one. Here's an ASMR for you. So we're gonna go ahead and check the oil while we got it up in the air and flat. Oh, and my child just showed up with her friend. Obviously too late to help me. Everybody say hi. Oh, she's got my sticker on and my wife's sticker. There goes the child.
Awesome, I got her.
This is my daughter's friend. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, how are you?
Good. All right, so we're gonna check the oil while we got her in the air. And probably about a half a quart low, so we're gonna get a quart in. All right, so this takes 5W40. I like liquid moly because it's, it comes in an easy size to use. Let me not over pour this. And it is what they use in MotoGP, so it's recommended for BMWs. There's always the debate whether a bike should be standing up, on its side, whatever, when you're checking the oil. I'm just gonna throw this out there. If it's showing on the dipstick, you have enough oil. If it's not showing on the dipstick, you don't have enough oil. Anything in between, that's up to you and your God. You definitely don't want too much, because you will start blowing it out the vent, no matter what kind of brand it is. Harley, Honda, Suzuki, whatever. And if you don't have enough to show on the dipstick, then you definitely don't know how much oil is in it. Bye, Adrian. Have a good one. All right, we have just enough. So let's close her up, clean up our mess, and let's not forget to get these back on our trapdoor. I mentioned I live near an airport. No need for anti-seize on these or Loctite. Okay, so we're done. So let's get all of our stuff put away, and hey, hopefully this helped you out a little bit with something you need to do. Remember, if you want this, I've already definitely made it up. I can definitely send it back out to you. I actually got this from somebody else and made a few revisions to it. So if this will help you out, definitely. All right, guys, until next time, don't forget to subscribe, comment, and hit the bell below for more updates. Bye.